यूनिट 6 पार्ट 4 फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन टू फेज लॉक लूप दैट इज PLL. अ फेज लॉक लूप दैट इज PLL इज अ निगेटिव फीडबैक सिस्टम कंसिस्ट ऑफ फेज डिटेक्टर लो पास फिल्टर एंड वोल्टेज कंट्रोलर दैट इज VCO विद इन इट्स लूप. इट्स पर्पज इज टू सिंक्रोनाइज एन आउटपुट सिग्नल विद रेफरेंस और इनपुट सिग्नल इन फ्रिक्वेंसी एज वेल एज इन फेज. The phase lock loop or phase lock loop or PLL is a control system that generates output signal whose phase is related to the phase of an input signal. There are several different types. The simplest is an electronic circuit consisting of variable frequency oscillator and phase detector in feedback loop. The oscillator generates a periodic signal and the phase detector compares the phase of that signal with phase of the input periodic signal, adjusting the oscillator to keep the phases matched. Keeping the input and output phase in lock step also implies keeping the input and output frequencies the same. Consequently, in addition to synchronizing signals, a phase lock loop can track an input frequency or it can generate a frequency that is multiple of input frequency. These properties are used for computer clock synchronization, demodulation, and frequency synthesis. In the synchronized or locked state, the phase error between the oscillator's output signal and the reference signal is zero or it remains constant. If a phase error builds up, a control mechanism acts on the oscillator to reduce the phase error to minimum so that the phase of the output signal is actually locked to the phase of the reference signal. This is why it is called a PLL. The majority of PLL applications fall into four main categories. The frequency synthesizer, most widely used, so PLL is also referred as a frequency synthesizer. The FM, that is frequency and phase, that is PM modulation and demodulation, data and carrier recovery, tracking filters. Classification of PLL, analog or linear PLL, digital PLL is analog PLL with digital PLL detector. All digital PLL is a digital loop in two senses, all digital components and all digital discrete time signals. Keeping the input and output phase in lock step also implies keeping the input and output frequencies the same. The phase lock loop are widely employed in radio, telecommunication, computer and other electronic applications. They can be used to demodulate a signal, recover a signal from a noisy communication channel, generate a stable frequency at multiples of an input frequency, or distribute precisely timed clock pulses in digital logic circuits such as microprocessor. Since a single integrated circuit can provide a complete phase lock loop building block, the technique is widely used in modern electronic devices with output frequencies from a fraction of hertz up to many gigahertz. The phase lock loop is basically a closed loop system. Its application is to lock the output frequency and the phase of input signal. It is also used for the communication circuit in two different ways, for demodulation application and second is synchronization of the signal. The PLL principle is used in applications such as FM demodulation, FSK demodulation, motor speed control, frequency multiplication and division. Now, the brief history of PLL. In 1932, the invention of coherent communication using vacuum tube. 1943, horizontal and vertical sweep synchronization in television. 1954, color television. In 1965, PLL or integrated circuit. In 1970, the classical digital PLL. in 72 all digital PLL today in every cell phone, TV, radio, pager, computer. Clock and data recovery, frequency synthesis, clock generation, clock skew minimization, duty cycle enhancement. The spontaneous synchronization of weakly coupled pendulum clocks was noted by the Dutch physicist Christian in 1673. Around the turn of 19th century, it is observed that the synchronization of weakly coupled organ pipes and tuning forks by Rayleigh. The phase lock loop circuit exists in wide variety of high frequency application, from simple clock cleanup circuit to local oscillator for high performance radio communication link and ultra fast switching frequency synthesizers in vector network analysis. The phase locked loop takes in a signal to which it locks, and it can then output this signal from its own internal VCO. At the first sight, this may not appear particularly useful, but with a little ingenuity, it is possible to develop a large number of phase locked loop applications. Now this diagram shows the block diagram of PLL, which consists of phase detector, low pass filter and VCO, that is voltage controlled oscillator. So first block is phase detector. The two inputs to a phase detector or the comparator are input voltage VI at frequency FI and the feedback voltage from the voltage control oscillator at frequency FO. The phase detector compares the two signals and produces a DC voltage VE, which is proportional to the phase difference between the FI and FO. That is input frequency and frequency from the voltage controlled oscillator. The output voltage VE of the phase detector is called error voltage. This error is then applied to the low pass filter. Now there are three types of the phase detector: analog, digital and flip-flop. So the phase detector generate a voltage which represent the phase difference between the two signals. In PLL, the two inputs of the phase detector are the reference input and the feedback from the VCO. There are different types of the phase detector which have different performance characteristics. For instance, the frequency mixer produces harmonics that adds complexity in application, where spectral purity of the VCO signal is important. The resulting unwanted sidebands are also called as reference pores, which can dominate the filter requirement and reduces the capture range well below or increase the lock time beyond the requirement. In this application, the more complex digital phase detectors are used, which do not have as severe a reference component on their output. Also, when in log, the steady state phase difference at the input using this type of the phase detector is near 90 degree. In PLL application, it is frequently required to know when the loop is out of log. The more complex digital phase frequency detector usually have an output which allows a reliable indication of an out of log condition. Next is low pass filter. The low pass filter removes the high frequency noise present in the phase detector output and it produces a ripple free DC level. This DC level is amplified to an adequate level and applied to a voltage which is controlled oscillator. The DC amplifier output voltage is called as a control voltage VC. Now this block, commonly called the PLL loop filter or low pass filter, which has two distinct functions. The primary function is to determine the loop dynamics, also called as stability. This is how the loop responds to the disturbances, such as the changes in the reference frequency, changes of the feedback driver, or at startup. Common considerations are the range over which the loop can achieve a log, how fast the loop achieves the log, and damping behavior. Depending on the application, this may require one or more of the following, that is a simple proportion, gain or attenuation, an integral, that is low pass filter, and or a derivative, a high pass filter. The loop parameters commonly examined for these are loops, gain margin, and phase margin. Common concepts in control theory, including the PID controller, are used to design this function. The second common consideration is limiting the amount of reference frequency energy, that is ripple, appearing at the phase detector output, that is then applied to the VCO control input. This frequency modulates the VCO and produces FM sidebands, commonly called reference pores. The design of this block can be dominated by either of these considerations, or it can be a complex process juggling the interactions of the two. Typical trade-offs are increasing the bandwidth usually degrades the stability, or too much damping for better stability will reduce the speed and increase the setting time. Often also the phase noise is affected. Next is, last block is voltage controlled oscillator. The control voltage VC is applied at the input of the VCO. The output frequency of the VCO is directly proportional to the DC control voltage VC. The VCO frequency F0 is compared with the input frequency FI by the phase detector, and it, that is VCO frequency, is adjusted continuously until it is equal to the input frequency FI. All phase lock loop employ an oscillator element with variable frequency capability. This can be an analog VCO, either driven by the analog circuitry in the case of APLL, or driven digitally through the use of digital to analog converter as in the case of some DPLL design. Pure digital oscillators such as numerically controlled oscillator are used in ADPLLs. Now, how are the PLLs are used? So, the frequency synthesis, for example, generating a 1 GHz clock from a 100 MHz reference in a CPU. So, here diagram is given, which shows the reference clock given to the PLL and we get the VCO clock. Second is extracting a clock from a random data stream, for example, serial link clock data recovery. So here the here is a random data stream which is given to the PLL and we get the VCO clock. And the third is reference cleanup, for example, low pass filter source synchronous clock in high speed IO. The diagram for this is shown here. Now basic PLL system. Now this diagram shows the basic PLL system. Which has a phase detector as a first block, loop filter as a second block, and the VCO, that is voltage controlled oscillator, as a third block. Input to the phase detector, there are two inputs, Vin and the output of VCO, which is continuously compared. And the output of this phase detector is the difference between these two signals, which is given to the loop filter, which attenuates the high frequency, and the output of the loop filter is given to the VCO. Now the diagram for this, or the graph for these all blocks, are shown here. The first is the reference input, second is the feedback. These two are given to the phase detector, output of the phase detector, and the last is loop filter output. The basic PLL block diagram consists of these three elements, which is shown earlier, three components connected in feedback loop: phase detector or phase frequency detector, which produces a signal V phi proportional to the phase difference between the F in and F oscillator signal. Loop filter filters the output voltage V out that controls the frequency of the VCO, and a voltage controlled oscillator V out at the input of the VCO determine the frequency F oscillator of the periodic signal V oscillator at the output of VCO. A basic property of the PLL attempts to maintain the frequency lock, that is F oscillator equal to F in, between the V oscillator and V in, even if the frequency F in of the incoming signal varies in the time. Assume the PLL is in locked condition and the frequency F in of the incoming signal increases slightly. The phase difference between the VCO signal and the incoming signal will begin to increase in time. As a result, the filtered output voltage V out increases, the VCO output frequency F oscillator increases until it matches to input frequency, thus keeping the PLL in locked condition. The PLL may include a divider between the oscillator and the feedback input to the phase detector to produce a frequency synthesizer. A programmable divider is particularly useful in radio transmit application, since a large number of transmit frequencies can be produced from a single stable, accurate but expensive quartz crystal controlled reference oscillator. Some PLL also include a divider between the reference clock and reference input to the phase detector. If the divider in the feedback path divides by N and the reference input divider divides by M, then it allows the PLL to multiply the reference frequency by N by M. It might seem simpler to just feed the PLL a lower frequency, but in some cases the reference frequency may be constrained by other issue, and then the reference divider is useful. The frequency multiplication can also be attained by locking the VCO output to the nth harmonic of the reference signal. Instead of simple phase detector, the design uses a harmonic mixer. The harmonic mixer turns the reference signal into an impulse train that is rich in harmonics. The VCO output is a coarse tuned to be close to one of those harmonics. Consequently, the desired harmonic mixer output falls within the loop filtered passband. It should also be noted that the feedback is not limited to a frequency divider. This element can be other elements such as frequency multiplier or mixer. The multiplier will make the VCO output a submultiple of the reference frequency. A mixer can translate the VCO frequency by a fixed offset, and it may also be a combination of these. An example being a divider following a mixer. This allows the divider to operate at much lower frequency than the VCO without a loss in loop gain. Stages of PLL operation. There are three stages of PLL operation: free running stage, capture stage, and phase locked stage. In free running stage, when there is no input is applied at the phase detector, the PLL output frequency, that is F, is F oscillator equal to FO, where FO is free running frequency of the VCO. Now in this diagram, these three stages are shown. Second is capture stage, or the capture stage, when an input is applied to the phase detector, and due to the feedback mechanism, PLL tries to track the output with respect to input. And the third is phase locked stage. Due to the feedback mechanism, the frequency comparison stops when F oscillator is equal to F in. Lock range and capture range of PLL. The lock range of the PLL is the range of the frequencies where the locked PLL remains in the locked. So F in is in between F minimum and F max. The lock range is wider than the capture range. If the PLL is initially locked and if F in is in between F max and F minimum, then the PLL becomes unlocked condition. That is, F oscillator is not equal to F in. Now when the PLL is unlocked, the F oscillator equal to FO, where FO is the center frequency or the free running frequency of the VCO. Next is capture range of the PLL. The lock can be established again if the incoming signal frequency F in gets close enough to the FO. The range of the frequency is such that initially unlocked PLL becomes locked. Sometimes a frequency detector is added to the phase detector to assist in initial acquisition of the lock. Loop filter. The output V phi of T of the phase detector is filtered by the low pass filter, and the purpose of this low pass filter is to pass the DC and the low frequency portions of V phi of T, and to attenuate high frequency AC component at frequencies 2 pi f in. The simple RC filter has a transfer function fs is equal to 1 divided by 1 plus SRC, that is equal to 1 by 1 plus s by omega p, where omega p is 1 by RC and fp is omega p by 2 pi. It is the cutoff frequency of the filter. If fp is less than 2f in, then the output of the filter V out is approximately equal to the DC component V phi of the phase detector output. In practice, the high frequency component are not completely eliminated, and it can be observed as high frequency AC ripple around the DC or slowly varying VO. In general, the filter output V out as a function of the phase difference. Note that here V out is 0 if V in and V oscillator are in phase, that is phi is equal to 0, and that it reaches the maximum value V out equal to VDD when the two signals are exactly out of the phase. So phi is equal to pi. For phi in between 0 to pi, V0 increases, and for phi greater than pi, V0 decreases. The characteristic of the periodic in phi with period 2 pi, here it is shown. The range of phi in between 0 to pi is the range where the PLL can operate in the locked condition. Voltage controlled oscillator, that is VCO. In PLL application, the VCO is treated as a linear time invariant system. To obtain an arbitrary output frequency within the VCO tuning range, a finite V out is required. Let's define V oscillator minus phi oscillator minus phi in equal to phi 0. The XOR function produces an output pulse whenever there is a phase misaligned.
Suppose that an output frequency omega 1 is needed, then from the upper right figure, we can see that the control voltage V1 will be necessary to produce this output frequency. The phase detector can produce this V1 only by maintaining a phase offset phi at its input. In order to minimize the required phase offset or the error, the PLL loop gain KD K0 should be maximized, since phi is equal to V1 by KD, that is equal to omega 1 minus omega 0 divided by KD into K0. Now here the diagram shows the graph for V in of T, V oscillator, phase error and V0. Thus, a high loop gain KD K0 is beneficial for reducing the phase error. Now note that from phase detector, V1 is equal to KD into phi, so phi is equal to V1 by KD. And from VCO, V1 equal to omega 1 minus omega 0 by K0, so phi is equal to V1 by KD, which is equal to V1 omega 1 minus omega 0 divided by KD into K0. Now next is PLL IC565. Now the phase lock loop is one of the vital block in the linear system, and it is useful in the communication system such as radar, satellite, FM, etc. Now the IC 565 is the